State legislator says the group pushing to decriminalize marijuana in Wichita is wasting its time. Kansas for Change submitted its petitions to lower fines for pot possession today. Now, the group hopes the issue will be on the April ballot, but even if voters approve the measure, KAKE's Madeline Anderson explains why opponents say it won't have any legal effect.
Local municipalities have the power to establish their own ordinances without the state's interference. It's called home rule authority. However, when an ordinance is in direct conflict with a state law, then state trumps local. Some say that's how it will play out with marijuana. According to Kansas state statute, a first offense for marijuana possession is considered a Class A misdemeanor. Petitioners hoping to lower those penalties in Wichita want a first offense dropped down to an infraction.
Their petition would clearly be in conflict with what is existing state law. And so essentially they've kind of wasted their time.
Representative Steve Brunk is against decriminalizing marijuana. He's also the chairman of the Federal and State Affairs Committee and says because of the limitations of home rule authority, there will be little, if any, legal impact, even if voters say yes to changing the law in Wichita.
So if they want the law changed, then what they really need to do is go to the state level and have the state law changed, not work at the city level.
In response, Esau Freeman, the man spearheading the pot reform effort, says the state should instead spend its time focusing on more pressing issues.
We have a budget fall, a shortfall to worry about. We have a lot of other things that they could be worrying about than, you know, this petition.
And petitioners say they've collected around 4,500 signatures. At least 2,900 must be valid for the city council to take action and put it on the April ballot.